Senator Bongo also lashing out at former Senator Antonio Trillanes for resurrecting claims which he already responded to in 2018. Go insists he never influenced the Department of Public Works and Highways to grant favors to projects related to his family's business. He adds the joint venture underwent public bidding and scrutiny.
Paano naging plunder laban sa akin at kay Pangulong Duterte ang isang lehitimong transaksyon ng gobyerno na wala naman kaming kinalaman? Sinabi ko na sa kanya noon na kung mapapatunayan niya ang paratang niya, magre-resign kaagad ako. Nakalipas na po ang halos 3 taon at wala namang napatunayan si Trillanes. Trillanes, huwag ka na magpaligoy-ligoy pa. Kung tingin mo may korupsyon na nangyari, kasuhan mo na para mapanagot. May proseso at hukuman na makapagpapatunay ng mga yan.
In other news, Malacañang unfazed by corruption allegations made by former Senator Antonio Trillanes. The former lawmaker accused President Rodrigo Duterte and his longtime aide Senator Bongo of committing plunder after relatives of Go scored dozens of government contracts despite being unqualified. The amount, 6.6 billion pesos. Trillanes vows to file plunder complaints against Duterte and Go once they are out of office. But palace spokesperson Harry Roque was quick to deny his claims.
Lumantugtugin na po yan. Binatunan niya yan kay Presidente, kay Senator Bongo, hindi pa Senador si Senator Bongo. Wala naman siya napatunayan nung siya ay nakaupo pa sa Senado.
Ito ang pangako ko. Basta pag nawala na sila sa pwesto, ipa-file namin ang mga kasong plunder kina Duterte at Bongo base dito sa mga government documents na ito.
Trillanes has expressed his intention to run for the 2022 national elections. President Duterte last week declared himself a vice presidential candidate, while Senator Bongo has been ranking high in recent presidential surveys.
Senator Bong Revilla now cleared of all pork barrel scam charges after the Sandigan Bayan on Monday jumped the graft charges against him due to insufficiency of evidence presented by the prosecution. This dismissal follows his acquittal of plunder in December 2018 in connection still with the millions of Priority Development Assistance Fund supposedly diverted to bogus non-governmental organizations ran by pork barrel scam queen Janet Lim Napoles. Napoles, along with Revilla's now deceased former aide Richard Cambe, were both convicted of plunder. A divided Sandigan Bayan Special First Division voted 3-2 to junk the graft charges against Revilla while upholding the case against Napoles. Among the reasons the anti-graft court cited for the dismissal of charges, Revilla's endorsement were supposedly recommendatory, adding there was no established evidence that Revilla received kickbacks. Also, Revilla could no longer be charged with graft for the same acts that were the basis for the plunder charge. A dud, that's how the palace described the supposed bombshell of Senator Manny Pacquiao on alleged corruption in several government agencies. The heads of those agencies also emphatically denied irregularities on the projects mentioned by the boxing icon-turned-lawmaker. The Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission, meanwhile, says they are already looking into Pacquiao's allegations, but PACC Commissioner Greco Belica says they may be challenging to pursue as the senator has already left for the U.S. to train for an upcoming boxing match.
Well, Watusi po. Akala ko atom bomb, yung pala Watusi. Wala po, walang kwenta. Kasi puro generalized allegations po. Walang bill of particulars, walang specific instance, walang ebidensya. Wala man lang follow-up.
Hindi ko malaman kung paano mag-iimbestiga. Dahil nang wala siya, dahil parang ang hirap po dahil siya po ang proponent ng mga issues na to. And so sino ang tatanungin namin sa mga issues niya?